chosen by Rabbi Lanami, and the prophet for all humanity to spread the word. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Listen to the ocean. Listen to the waves crashing. Look up and look at the stars of His. Look at the creation of Allah Azza wa Jal. Look at the billions of grains of sand that you are sitting on. And look at the trees that surround us. Subhanak Ya Rab. Subhanak Ya Rab, that all of His creation, be it the earth, be it the ocean, be it the trees, be it the animals, be it insan, be it the jinn, be it the prophets, be it the angels, be it Jibreel, be it Israfil, everything is dead except Allah Azza wa Jal. Everything is dead. Everything is dead except Allah Azza wa Jal. Nothing moves, nothing stops, nothing makes, and nothing breaks except by His will. Is Allah not perfect? Is Allah not perfect? Everything He does is perfect. His creation is perfect. His Nabi is perfect. His Deen is perfect. His Rahmah is perfect. And my brothers, His punishment is perfect. On the day of judgment, when all of man, from Adam to the last of them, will stand in front of Allah Azza wa Jal, and all of the jinn, they will stand in front of Allah Azza wa Jal, and Allah Azza wa Jal will call. He will call for Nar Jahannam to be brought forward. He will call upon the angels to bring forward hellfire. Picture this. Picture this. 70,000 ropes. Each rope has 70,000 angels. That's 4.9 billion. 4.9 billion angels. And they will drag Nar Jahannam forward. They will bring it as they have been commanded. They will bring it forward. And we will be watching. We will be watching. When Nar Jahannam sees the disbelievers and the sinners for the first time, it will burst in anger. It will burst in anger. Such a sound that the 4.9 billion angels will let go of the ropes. When it sees the disbelievers and the sinners for the first time, Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran that everything, men, jinn, and angels, when Nar Jahannam will burst, everything will fall to its knees. Everything will fall to its knees. Allah is perfect in everything He does, and He's perfect in His punishment. What can I tell you about Nar Jahannam? What can I tell you? Rasulullah was sitting with his companions and they heard a sound. He says to them, did you hear that? They said to him, yes, Ya Rasulullah. He said to him, do you know what it is? They said to him, Wallahu wa Rasulu A'lam. He said to him, this is a rock that was thrown into hellfire 70 years ago, and only now did it reach the bottom. Only now did it reach the bottom. How big? 4.9 billion. But that's not the scary thing. Allah Azza wa Jal is promising Nar Jahannam that you will be full. I will fill you up. Halim Talakti, he says to it, are you full? Is there any more room? And it says to him, Almin Mazid, bring it on. Is there any more? Is there any more? This is what I was designed for. This is what I was created for. Bring them on. Is there any more? The least punishment in hellfire is a man will be made to stand on two burning coals. He will be made to stand and his brain will boil. And the miskin thinks that he's copping the worst punishment. He thinks he's copping the worst punishment. Rasulullah said, this is the least punishment. What do you think he done? Did he miss a prayer? Did he tell a white lie? Did he neglect the sunnah? What was it, Ya Rasulullah, the least punishment? Your brain will boil. Allah is perfect in everything He does. He is perfect in His creation. He is perfect in His rahmah. And He is perfect in His punishment.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
إِذَا أُلْقُوا فِيهَا سَمِعُوا لَهَا شَهِيقًا وَهِيَ تَفُورُ تكاد تميز من الغيظ كلما ألقي فيها فوج سألهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم نذير قالوا بلى قد جاءنا نذير فكذبنا وقلنا ما نزل الله من شيء إن أنتم إلا في ضلال كبير وقالوا لو كنا نسمع أو نعقل ما كنا في أصحاب السعير فاعترفوا بذنبهم فسحقا لأصحاب السعير.